Radio Jesterowo.
Ja oglądam rechow Radio Jesterowi.
Our station, our talent, our people.
Ty dang raki.
Ya, Molweni makhaya,
Single Radio East River sifumaneka kuzo zonke social media platforms.
Yes,
our station, our talent, our people.
Didang Rocky.
Ya, Didang Rocky. Good afternoon. It's Tuesday the 27th of February. And it's Tuesday afternoon, just after 4 o'clock, in fact 4:06. And so good to have you with us. If you're hearing my voice, then you are tuned into the leading internet radio station in South Africa. And we are so excited and glad to have you with us. And that radio station, of course, is Radio Eersterivier. Onse stars, onse talent en onse mense. And our signature tune there that you heard was Hy Maak 'n Weg, a bit of a jazzed up version there of Hy Maak 'n Weg. And that has become almost like a national anthem to churches in the Western Cape at least. Thank you so much for tuning in. We are greeting you live from a sunny mother city, where it's, the thermometer stopped at just about bearable 32 degrees, and but we're in the studio and it's nice and cool here. And imparting from my normal MO, we are give you how to track with us. I want to get straight into it to introduce our guest to you today. I've got two of my good friends and ministry colleagues with me in studio today, men that are highly esteemed, not just in Cape Town, in South Africa, but also abroad. I think they, in fact, need no introduction at all. They are household names in our city, and they are esteemed highly, and I'm so grateful and honored to have them as my friends as well. And so, yeah, I've got with me two bishops, Bishop Manny Niekerk and Bishop Andre Horn, and they respectively are the senior elders, the senior pastors, the angels, the apostles of two local houses. In fact, Bishop Manny of Kunjalu Love Fellowship Tabernacle and Bishop Andre Horn of Covenant of Peace Ministries out in Cravenby. Obviously, Kunjalu, we all know, is out in Holt Road, Elsies River. Bishop Manny, of course, is also the leader in Africa of the Covenant Keepers International Alliance under the exemplary leadership of multi-Grammy Award winner Bishop Hezekiah Walker, of course, and Bishop Horn also assists Bishop Manny as a deputy in that organization as well for Africa. So, listen, the credits, the credentials of these two men of God go on and on and on, and I know they don't want me to really focus on that this afternoon, but suffice it to say that these men are established, seasoned men of God in our city, and we're going to just enjoy them this afternoon. And what I'm going to do right now is just give Bishop Manny and also Bishop Horn then just an opportunity just to greet everybody, and we'll take it from there. Any one of the two of you can jump in straight away, Bishop Horn.
Yeah, good afternoon, Pastor Clay. It's great to be back with you guys.
Yeah,
this afternoon at Radio Eersterivier. Yeah, and also to the listeners, good afternoon. Yeah, God bless you.
Amen, Bishop.
Good afternoon, Pastor Clay, and a special greetings to the listeners of Radio Eersterivier. It's always nice to be with you guys, and also let me send a shout out to my wife, Antonina Niekerk, and the Gonzalo Church family. You are greeted in Jesus' name, and we trust that we're going to have a blessed time.
I'm sure Pastor Serene and Covenant of Peace is also tuned in, Bishop.
Yes, he is. He said to me she's going to check online.
Yeah. Okay, awesome. Awesome. No, so good to have you guys with us in the studio. Like I always say, and I've said it before when you guys were on, you know, we don't just get people on for the sake of getting them on, but we recognize what God is doing in and through your lives, and we celebrate you. Bishop Andre Horn, Bishop Manny Niekerk, we celebrate you. They say that fruit don't lie. And so your fruit speaks for itself. It's undeniable. The call of God is undeniable on your lives. And so we just pray that God would even further extend your territory, enlarge your territory. And I think the saying, the best is yet to come, almost becomes cliche in the Christian community. Yeah. But I wanna use it in any case and say that I truly believe that the best is yet to come for both of you. And so I'm extremely excited to have them in the studio. Yeah, let me just quickly mention, we on TikTok, we live on TikTok as well. Now I don't even know how TikTok works, but we live on there. yeah, we live on Facebook, of course. That's the Radio Easter of a Facebook page. Then we also have a WhatsApp number in the studio if you should feel to interact with us in that way. And the number there is 064-536-9095. Ja, die brein raaks 'n bietjie oud, ek kan nie al die goed meer so recall nie. But yeah, so that's the, and also you can track with us obviously via our website, which is www.radioeastriver.co.za. And yeah, I think you know all the other things that we say every week. So yeah, just to everybody that's tuned in as well, do me a favor, please share the broadcast. You know, share at least 5 times on, you know, to friends. Copy the link and put it into your WhatsApp groups. Invite people to come on, because I'm sure we are going to have a blessed time this afternoon. The program, of course, is Table Talk, and our tagline there comes from Proverbs 23 and verse 7, which says that as a man thinks, so is he. And our tagline is, we challenge mindsets in order to change lives. And as I say, the basis for that comes from Proverbs 23 and verse 7. And yeah, I think with that said, we're going to go to a quick music break just to give the bishops a chance to catch their breath. And then when we come back, we're going to get straight into it with our topics today. So please don't go away. Get your pen, your paper, get your coffee, whatever you prefer to drink. Los nie die harde hout wanneer jy moet luister.
Yes.
But yeah, we're going to go to a music break. The first song we're going to listen to is by Bishop Hezekiah Walk, and it's called You All I Need.
Enjoy Samsung Galaxy AI technology this fantastic Friday. Save 7,200 Rand when you get the new Samsung Galaxy S24 for only 699 Rand per month on an Elevate 2 contract. Plus, get 30 gigs free data to experience Samsung Galaxy AI. Go in store or call 084-145. Valid 23 Feb to 3 March. Switch to Cell C today. Now on SA's best network. T's and C's apply. Cell C. Change your world.
Wanna be, wanna talk closer,
wanna talk closer,
if I,
hey,
if I, Enjoy Samsung Galaxy AI technology this fantastic Friday. Save 7,200 Rand when you get the new Samsung Galaxy S24 for only 699 Rand per month on an Elevate 2 contract. Plus, get 30 gigs free data to experience Samsung Galaxy AI. Go in store or call 084-145. Valid 23 Feb to 3 March. Switch to Cell C today. Now on SA's best network. T's and C's apply. Cell C. Change your world.
We are back. We are back. The program, of course, is Table Talk on Radio East River. And we are so excited today to have Bishop Manny Niekerk and Bishop Andre Horn with us this afternoon, two of my good friends in ministry, but also friends outside of ministry. And so I'm thankful to have them with us now. You know, we're going to be talking about growth in a moment, growth, and just see how far we get with that. And then if there is time, we're going to get into the power of unity. But I want to kick off with this question to both the bishops. And, you know, they've both been in ministry for 20 years, even longer, you know, and leading ministry and that sort of thing. And the question I have, bishops, is... if you had to give a young Andre Horn and a young Manny Niekerk advice today, if you could go back 20 years and say to young Andre and to young Manny Horn, Niekerk, what to watch out for in ministry, the pitfalls or something like this, just, you know, what would it be?
Yeah, Pastor Clay, I think... first and foremost, it's important for young ministers to have the understanding that I think the very first requirement is that you got to make sure that you've been sent.
Mm-hmm.
I think because, sure, you know, we should not move away from the principles of God.
Yeah.
And so before you can start anything, the very first question to be asked, who did send you?
Wow.
And so, yeah, that is a point of departure, because if that is intact, if that is in place, then automatically the second key principle that's important, one would have understanding that there is covering. And so when there is covering, it simply means there's accountability.
Yeah.
And so that becomes important as one starts. Then I think you know it is important for young ministers to have the understanding that you should not be moved by what you see. But you should know who you are.
Come on, come on.
Because if you lack to identify and know who you are, you will just do copy and paste. And so if you know who you are, it simply means you won't be intimidated by others, by what you see. It simply means you will embrace your own race and run your race at your own pace.
Come on,
and
come on.
Because you would understand that your purpose is to serve God's kingdom.
Yeah.
And so the kingdom then will become priority. And as the kingdom become priority, you don't get moved.
Yeah.
You are not jealous about nobody. You will learn not to compete. You will learn to complete.
And
that will become your nature. And you will be, but you got to be comfortable with yourself with God. You got to understand your assignment.
There's someone won't fall on after Scorpio. I mean, we could, I don't know if you want to just jump in with that or add on to that, Bishop, or before you get to your point.
Basically, now what I would love to say is that I would say to a young minister of, you know, when I look at my life, you know, over the many years of pastoring a church, I also had, you know, a crazy head back then. But I would say to a young minister, always stick to the greater purpose of the calling. Not get it twisted with the flashiness. You know, because people try to portray or try to make people understand that, you know, when you have a title, that you are this big sort or whatever, you know. But never get it twisted in this is also now what I notice now, you know, over the years. Don't get it twisted in name branding. You know, first establish solid character.
Yeah.
you know, and that will make it easy on the call,
sure.
Because listen, people don't always connect to what you preach about. They connect to who you, how you carry yourself.
So
that is just my few cents.
I love that because you know, Bishop Manny spoke about, you know, knowing who you are.
Yeah,
you speaking about you know, look to develop your character.
You're
absolutely right because you know people run on gifting. You know, and the gift the Bible says will make room for but the character sometimes comes short.
That is what establishes you.
You know, and so that is powerful, bishops. I don't know if you guys want to just add anything to that, because since we could actually run with that, we could actually run with that. But so just to recap, covering, mentorship, accountability, and then character, knowing we are, don't go for the flashiness. Because jy ouens dink ons, man, hulle kyk hoe 'n man nie aantrek en hoe 'n hoorn aantrek en so aan, en hulle sien nie, en hulle sien die ministry en die invitations en so hulle dink nee, as ek daai kan copy, if I can copy that outward. But they don't know what you've been through to get there.
And now, Pastor Clay. Now, with focusing too much on the fleshiness. You know, then you started missing your call because now your focus is on numbers. On quantity. Because you must now uphold some whatever. You understand? So now people becomes commodity to you. You know, and that is where the danger starts, because if I now can get the 100 or the 50 or I mean the 100 or the 500, then I can make good money, you know, so that I can, you know, uphold this whatever lifestyle.
Plenty dangers. Yes, Bishop.
I think it's also important as one encourages young and upcoming ministers, because we got to be transparent. And I believe one should not be too hard on yourself. Make room for mistakes.
Wow, I love that.
We all have made mistakes.
Absolutely.
And so we all continue to learn to become whom God wants us to be in His kingdom.
Sure.
Sometimes when we do encourage the young ministers, we encourage them from a viewpoint as if we have never made mistakes. And so there's got to be room to make mistakes. However, if we take God on His word, as we make mistakes, we learn from that mistake. We become better. We do better. Sometimes we fall short of the glory of God, you know. But He is a loving, caring, righteous God. A forgiving God. And so God embraces us. The key thing remains, we should not get stuck in the mistake.
Come on.
You know,
love it.
We should pull ourselves out of the mistake. Rectify the mistake, and that is when we will make progress.
I love what you said, Bishop, and this maybe we will round this this short segment off with this. You speak about being transparent with young ministers or whoever we're mentoring. And it just brings me back to the point how important it is to have somebody that covers you.
Yes, sir.
Because I think very often now also, you know, the very often the mentors don't want to be transparent. They don't want because ons ken mos die Christen grapevine. As ek nou iets hier share met jou van hoe vulnerable om my vulnerabilities met jou share, dan leer die hele plek vol. But the thing is, I think it's important. I'll never forget, just with Pastor Neil, how we used to sometimes share some of his issues. And that gave me a new respect every time that he opened up and shared something like that, because it made me realize he's human too.
Obviously, you cannot be transparent with everybody.
Come on.
Absolutely.
Everybody cannot be privy to your private life.
Come on.
And so, but I believe if you have a mentor, you know, if you have a covenant brother, there gotta be people in your life where you can just be you,
sure,
and absolutely be transparent about what you face. facing, what you're going through.
Mm.
And that is how we strengthen one another.
Come on, sure.
Because the Bible teaches us, yeah, in the counsel of many.
This is wisdom, yeah.
So we strengthen one another when we engage and we say with one another.
Yeah, yeah.
But we got to be careful not to open ourselves
up. Oh, love it. Everybody. Love it, love it.
Absolutely.
I think it was at one of the first Covenant Keepers conferences many years back when Bishop Liston Page was here, when he was one, yes, of the speakers. He ministered a message on open rebuke is better than love concealed.
Yeah. Concealed.
But in there he spoke about, you know, you need at least two or three guys that you can go to.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yeah, you know, like in the middle of the night, ek sukkel hier staan nou met 'n ding of, you know, I'm battling with this. And you're not going to get, when you phone them at 3 o'clock in the morning, say, hey, nee man, ik slaap nou man.
Yeah. Exactly.
You know, but somebody that you can trust and you can go to. Yeah.
Yeah, and that's everything to do with maturity, you know.
Yeah.
Because you, as Bishop Manny said, you can't just open up to
anybody
person,
yeah,
you know,
yeah,
you know, they got to be able to be matured, you know,
yeah,
because jy wil nie oopmaak aan 'n ou wat hom gaan groot doodskrik op pas die klei bekend gemaak het, you know why,
yeah,
battle,
yeah,
you know, so you got to be able to have someone that you can trust.
Just on a bit of a lighter note, as we getting ready to go to our next music break, I'm reminded of the story where a group of pastors was getting together, you know, a lot of pastors, and the Spirit of God was moving. En die manne maak oop, jy begin oopmaak en die ene begin praat en hy sê, luister man, ek wil hê julle manne moet bid vir my, because jy weet, ek het 'n ding aan met die secretary by die kerk, man.
Wow.
Jy weet, en hierdie next auto, jy weet, en hy sê, ek is in charge van die kerk se geldkas, man, en ek kan nie my hande uithou, my vingers weghou nie, jy weet, en so gaan hulle aan, en die laaste ou sit, hy hou sy mond, hy sê absoluut niks, hy is doodstil. En die mense, die ouwens kyk ons, jy moet hom nou,
yeah.
Hy sê, my probleem is man, ek kan nie my mond hou nie. Ek kan nie wag om hier weg te kom nie.
Ek het
een story om te vertel. Nou, ja. Yeah. Okay, well, on that light note, but I know we've really just touched on some very serious things there as well, and I trust it has been a blessing to you, just that short segment, and that was unprepared. I didn't tell them we were going to do that, and so that was just off the cuff. And so that is the caliber of men that I have with me today. We're going to go into a piece of music right now, and when we come back, we're going to get into more with Bishop Andre Horn and Bishop Manny Niekerk.
Tune in to the leading internet radio station in the mother city, Radio Easter River. For more information, log on to our website, which is www.radioeasterriver.co.za.
Dependable God, it doesn't matter what comes my way, you are still God. Intentional God, everything is working out for my good. Dependable God, it doesn't matter what comes my way, you are still God. Yeah, yeah. Intentional God, everything is working out for my good. You love me too much, excess love, oh. You love me too much, excess love, oh. Thank you for loving me too much, oh. Thank you for loving me too much, oh, unconditionally. Thank you for loving me too much, oh. Thank you for loving me. What would I have been? Where would I have been without you? You love me too much, oh. Oh, kakame, nahin you be. You are A to Z, and everything in between, no. I'm a now you be the most high king. Eche tobie zike odiro yedikaki. Ama siamasio. Now you be the most high king. Eche tobie zike odiro yedikaki. Now I'm standing here only because you made. Now I'm standing here only because you made. Now I'm standing here only because you made a way.
Radio Esterivier, ons stasie, ons talent, ons mense. WhatsApp ons by 064-536-9095. Talk to us, die ding ruk hier.
We are back. It's Clayton Gabriels, your host of Table Talk, and I have with me, of course, Bishop Manny Niekerk. And also Bishop Andre Horn. Just acknowledge a few people that's online so far already. Just want to say thank you, Gail Adenol, for tuning in. It's all the way from Melkbosstrand side, that side. Thank you so much for tuning in. Also my wife has tuned in. Edwin Okes, good afternoon, leadership, he says. Michael Allen, Mickey Allen, that's a friend of ours from Boerasig side. Thank you, Mickey, for tuning in. Then First Lady Antonina Niekerk, she's tuned in. She says, thank you. That is so. This is so encouraging. Then Pastor Jacques January, our son in the faith, he says, blessings, Dad, with a prestigious guest, Bishop Manny and Bishop Andre Horn. And then my wife says, character is everything. Bishop Horn, you know, you got to know who you are, Bishop Manny. And then also Pastor Joanne Titus, she's tuned in. She says, it's a great program. And so on. So thank you guys for tuning in. Please continue to share the broadcast. Yeah, so I have my guests with me, and we're going to get into a topic which I know they have been dealing with extensively for the last maybe month or so in their own congregations and that sort of thing. And that's the topic of growth, and growth in its various aspects. And just to kick us off, I want to just read, and I read the scripture a couple of weeks ago as well when I had the privilege of ministering for Bishop Manny. And it comes from Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 11 through to 16, where it starts off by speaking about the fivefold ministry gifts, and then it says it's for the equipping of the saints. And verse 15 speaks about let me just find where I want to be. It says building up the body of Christ until we all attain to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to a mature man. So there already we see the growth aspect. We've got to get to a place of a mature man, to the measure of the stature which belongs to the fullness of Christ. And now it gives us a bit of a expounding a little bit there. It says, as a result, in other words, because we want to end up being mature, we are no longer to be children tossed here and there by waves and carried about by every wind of doctrine, by the trickery of men and the craftiness in deceitful scheming. But speaking the truth in love, we are to grow up There's the reference to growing up again, to grow up in all aspects into Him who is the head, even Christ, from whom the whole body, being fitted and held together by what every joint supplies, according to the proper working of each individual part, causes the growth of the body for the building up of itself in love. Now, we're speaking about growth and growth in general. Bishop Manny, I think, is going to kick us off just with a whatever God is laid on your heart in, with regards to that topic, and then Bishop Horn will also jump in.
Thank you, Pastor Clay. God spoke to me on this topic, growth. And I believe that even though it's our theme for 2024,
yeah,
growth should be a lifelong
theme.
You know, it cannot just be a once-off theme. The Apostle Peter encouraged us in 2 Peter 3:18, where he says, but grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And so I believe there is a responsibility.
Yeah.
You know, every believer do have that responsibility to grow in the wisdom, in the grace, and in the knowledge of Jesus Christ. And so we started off on New Year's Eve, and I preached from the book of Exodus and chapter 1 and verse 12, where the text says, "And but the more they afflicted them, the more they multiply and grew." And
wow.
I preach from the sermon title, you know, we got what it takes to grow.
Sure.
Because the Bible teaches us in this world we will face affliction, we will face, but you know, we have the ability to grow.
Yes.
But let me come and then the word grow to me, because I have 12 different subjects that I will speak through this year for each month.
Yeah, yeah.
And so I started off by speaking on, in order for one to grow, you need to get rid of old ways.
Yeah.
And I spoke about that, and I started off, in other words, the Apostle Paul in the book of Romans 12, you know, he made this appeal. He says, do not conform to the patterns of this world, but be transformed. In other words, we got to understand that we have been released from one kingdom, and we have been raised,
we've
been placed into another kingdom.
Yeah.
So now there was, our minds were conformed to the patterns of this world. Now Paul appealed to us, because in order for us to grow, there needs to be a mind shift.
Yeah,
transformation in the mind gotta take. And so now I was saying this thing, Pastor Clay, you cannot change what you refuse to confront.
Ooh.
So if I don't confront my old habits, my old attitudes, my old behavior, my old conduct, the flaws in my life, if I don't confront them, I won't be able to change them.
Yeah.
And so when we deal with be not conformed, that word conforms also speaks be not shaped after
the
patterns of the world. Because Jesus Christ himself became our pattern.
Yeah, come
and
on.
That's the pattern
that
we should
after
follow.
Which,
we should embrace his nature and character. And it's in that particular way that we should grow.
Yeah.
But in order to get there, we got to get rid of old ways
and
confront. And so when you confront, it simply means you acknowledge your old ways. And when you get to a place where you can acknowledge your shortcomings, acknowledge the areas in your life that need change, then only you can deal and position yourself into a season where transformation, renewal of the mind
can take place. Wow, powerful. Okay, we're going to get back to you in a moment. Bishop, I don't know if you want to jump in on that.
Yeah.
So just, you know, I know you've got...
Well, Bishop Manny was speaking. I was reminded of... we also on, you know, the aspect of growth.
Yeah.
And so our theme for 24 is grow beyond yesterday.
Mm.
So I was ministering a few weeks back on the text in Isaiah 43:18. Do not remember the former things.
Behold,
I'm going to do a new thing. You know?
Yeah.
And so with my focus on grow beyond yesterday, Pastor Clay, the Word of God reminds us that we are not meant to be confined by our past. So it's vitally important to understand, it is also the heart of God for us to grow. to get beyond where we at.
And
get to a place whereby we know, you know, there is also room within ourselves for progression. But if we can't break out of, and if we can't break out of comfort zones, you know, break out of what we, because sometimes it's easy to stick to what you are, what you know, you know,
comfortable,
because you become comfortable, you know. There is more, and it's literally, it's an insult to your to yourself and to your capabilities, you know.
Yeah.
And that is why my focus was on grow beyond yesterday. Scripture says, forget the former things.
Yeah.
The scripture says, never erase it. The scripture says, forget it.
You're trying
to forget the former things, but never erase it. Let it be still, you know, a lesson learned.
Yeah.
You know, and sometimes people are so, they comfortable because that's their same, their safe space.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Where they don't need to, you know, try to give new things a try, or to, you know, to go beyond, you know, what they comfortable with. And so therefore it becomes very vital, and it is important for people really, if you want to see your true potential, you know, what God has blessed you with, you know, your capabilities, your talents, your gifting, you will have to grow to a new place within yourself.
Wow. Yes. Awesome. Yeah.
If I can just jump in.
Jump in. Yeah. Bishop,
Bishop used the words. He spoke about comfort zones.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so, most of the time, comfort zones is a result of habits. Something that you
have
repetitively done.
Talk to us. Yeah.
And so when bad habits get entrenched, it becomes a stronghold.
Sure.
Now, it is important, and I'm going to try to put on my medical cap quickly for a minute.
Hey, Dr. Manny, yeah.
It is said that our brains form neural pathways and it associates itself with repetitive behaviors.
Yeah.
Okay, and so we all know that neural pathways is neurons are nerve cells. Now these nerve cells send messages to the brain. Now, as it sends messages to the brain, it establishes patterns. And so the patterns then, Bishop Horn, becomes the stronghold, which means it then controls us. And so now our nerve system is the part in our body that sends signals to the brain, and the brain responds accordingly. We eat because of the nerve cells. We walk because of the nerve cells. Because the nerve cells sends messages. So now it becomes a pattern, and the pattern becomes a stronghold. Hence we find that people tend to lapse. You have a person who has been addicted, addicted not to drugs, to alcohol or any other thing, but they then tend to fall back because a pattern
was established.
You know, through the signs and that the neurons, the nerve system is sending to the brain. Hence the Apostle Paul now comes. And the Apostle Paul said, now be not conformed to the patterns of the world. Because in our old life, and many times even in our spiritual walk, certain things become patterns. And the patterns is so entrenched that it became a stronghold.
Sure.
And so you would see somebody is committed to change.
Mm.
You would see somebody try their best, but then there is a relapse because we have not dealt in depth with the patterns that has been established in the mind. In the mind. And so there's the struggle, So hence, and if we don't confront it,
Come on, Bishop.
So there must be this willingness to step out of your comfort zone.
Yeah.
In order to break that pattern and that cycle, you know, and having a mind shift whereby you start, like the Bible says in the book of I think it's Luke chapter 15, the story of the prodigal son.
Yeah.
And the Bible says, and when he started to talk to himself,
he came to his senses.
He started to talk to himself. And you got to be able, in order for you to break out of the pattern, the system, and whatever you have established for yourself, you know, you will have to start to talk to yourself and tell yourself there is more than this.
Come on.
Come on. You understand?
Sure,
you can start to tell yourself there is more than this, then that will bring you to a place whereby you start making the move.
Yeah, to break out of, sure.
You know, so that you can grow beyond yesterday. And that is very, very vital. So you got to be also intentional about your growth.
Oh, I love that. Intentional.
You got to be intentional about growing and pursuing, you know.
Going to grow
within your, in yourself.
I love what the Apostle Paul says in Ephesians 4:22. He says, you were taught with regard to your former way of life.
Yeah.
To put off your old self,
which is being corrupted
by its deceitful desires.
To
be made new in the attitude of your minds.
Sure.
And to put on the new self created to be like God in the true righteousness and holiness.
Now,
I like the Message Bible.
Put
it this way.
Yeah.
The Message Bible talks about taking off your old clothes.
Come on.
And putting on some new clothes. Because you must embrace the saints.
Come on.
That took place since you have now since the transformation took place from the one kingdom into another kingdom. I was stingy, they struggled me to be a giver, but I embraced now what the kingdom is required.
I love you. You spoke earlier on about that Christ is the pattern.
Yes.
And now the scripture says, put on Christ.
Put on Christ.
Yeah, yeah.
Clothe yourself with Christ.
Yeah.
That's powerful.
Yeah. I love what the Bible says about in Daniel. Just thinking about, again, you guys are both speaking about the mind shift or the mindset shift or change.
Yeah.
And so the power of a made up mind.
Yeah.
The Bible says about Daniel, it says he made up his mind.
Yes, sir. Made up his mind.
Yeah. You know, and once you confront your thing, whatever your habit is, once you confront it and you start to renew your mind through the washing of the word, all of that stuff we know, you know, then there comes a point in time that I say, now I make up my mind that I'm not going back to that thing.
Yeah.
But how do we, because it's easy to say that I'm not going to go back. Well, how do we stay out of or away from not falling back into that thing again? Like you said, maybe the addict falls back into that thing because there's a pattern that was established. How do we stay out of that?
In dealing with get rid of old ways, I spoke about embracing a life of separation.
Okay.
2 Corinthians 6:17 says, wherefore come out from among them
and be separate, said
the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing. I will receive you, and I will be a father unto you, and ye shall be my sons and daughters, says the Lord God Almighty. This verse is a call to holiness and separation. Wow. Because the Bible teaches us that bad company
corrupts
what?
I feel like running around this room.
I want to get out, and I don't want to relapse again.
Sure.
And so my association then starts to matter.
Yeah.
I disassociate myself from folks that can corrupt my mind.
It's
almost like they will lit those old patterns again.
Wow, they will light it up again. Yeah.
To become alive again and then pulls me back from where. And hence the Apostle Paul now writes and he says, now he make this call for us to separate ourselves.
Come away from.
Come out from among them.
And be separate. And sometimes when you do that, a lot of people would say, "Yeah, but I don't guys die."
Yes.
But they don't understand.
Himself holier now.
Than thou, yeah. But the thing is, you gotta get to that place where you understand that your own sanity and your walk with God is more important than people's opinions. Yeah.
You gotta make a deliberate decision.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
You know that you're gonna just distance yourself.
Yeah.
Sure. Sure.
You gotta make a.
Yeah.
It gotta come from inside. Mm. It's a decision you gotta make.
Decision.
Powerful. That is powerful, Pastor Clay. And what I have found that what in growing yourself, it has everything also to do with your mindset.
Mm. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
You will have to take your mental capacity to a different place.
Yeah.
You understand, because when you are stuck with a specific mindset in your attempt to grow, you will never get to that place because if your mindset is messed up, if your mindset is in a place whereby I will never be, then that is what will happen to you ultimately, you know. And that is why it's important to take on the mind of Christ.
When taking
on the mind of Christ, it involves cultivating the qualities like love, peace, forgiveness, wisdom.
Be open to stuff like that.
Not to be stuck in your old ways, like Bishop Manny said, your patterns, you know, that system, having a routine of the same stuff, But putting on the mind of Christ. Because and you mentioned earlier the scripture when we came in Proverbs 23:7.
As
a man thinks, in his heart, so is he. You know, and it has everything to do with your mindset. And your mindset.
Mm. Yeah.
So when you acknowledge, when you identify, when you confront.
Yeah.
Then you get confronted with decision making.
Okay. Okay.
So now you gotta renounce.
Always.
You gotta reject it.
Wow.
Move away from.
Sure.
But as I renounce it, reject it, move away from it, I now need to pursue.
The new. Come on.
The new that I've embraced. I gotta pursue holiness. I gotta pursue the character and the nature of Jesus Christ.
Wow.
I have now put on
the new.
So now in order for you to put on the new and renew your mind, it means you will have to engage in a whole lot of spiritual practices.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
Pastor Clay, whereby you pray constantly.
Yes.
Yeah.
You're meditating the word constantly.
Yeah,
because
yeah.
you can't have put on the mind of Christ, you know, and renew yourself in the mindset whereby, you know, you want to grow out of that old place, and you know, you don't pray, you don't meditate the word, don't focus on studying the scriptures,
and
making time for God, you know. There's no way that you can live out of that place.
And
get beyond that place.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Mana? Sure. Yeah. Ooh,
kan je offer op.
Ja, nee, kijk, ik zal nog mijn bankdierel zassen op je. We're going to go to a music break. And you've heard what's already happened here and what's happening here. I mean, the power of God is flowing. It's the revelation is flowing. And we're going to go to a music break because we only have, like, with our guests, we only have like 15, 20 minutes left again. That's how fast the time is going because they have an appointment to get to. But we're going to go just to a short music break just to give them a breather, drink a little bit of water. And then when we come back, we're going to get right back into it. So, yeah. Over to a music break.
An unbeatable Samsung Galaxy deal for you this fantastic Friday. Get the Samsung Galaxy S22 for only 499 Rand per month on a 36-month Elevate 2 contract. Go in store or call 084145, valid from 23 Feb to 3 March. Switch to Cell C today, now on SA's most reliable network. T's and C's apply. Cell C, change your world.
Van al mijn
To the next level, advertise with Radio East River by emailing us at admin@radioeastriver.co.za.
You are listening to Radio East River.
Our station, our talent, our people.
Didang Rakhi. Ja, nee, ons is terug in die atelier, we're back in the studio, Radio Eesterhuwe, ons stasie, ons talent, ons mense, and my special guest today, Bishop Andre Horn, Senior Pastor of Covenant of Peace Ministries out of Cravenby, Ravensmead area, Elsies River area, and then also Bishop Manny Niekerk, Senior Pastor and Elder of Kunjalo Love Fellowship Tabernacle out in Holt Road, Elsies River as well. And like I said earlier on, they don't need any introduction. Just a quick just acknowledgement of some of the people that's online as well. We see that Cross Culture Family Fellowship is online. They all the way out of Houston. Bishop Pastor Davey and his congregation there. Thank you so much for tuning again. Pastor Antonina has also commented there and saying this is powerful tools. And then we have our friend all the way from Canada, Evelyn Mizell. Thank you so much, Evelyn, for tuning in. I know she's tuning in from work. It's early in the morning there, Canada. She's at work and she's got the earphones in. So thank you so much, Evelyn, for tuning in. Again, Pastor Joanne Titus as well. And then Sean Snugella, he says, character is really everything. Thank you so much for everybody that's tuned in. We're going to continue. And 2 weeks ago, I had the opportunity again, like I said, to minister at for Bishop Manny at Kunjalo. And I spoke on, you know, the still in the aspect of growth, but wisdom and wealth. And that aspect of growth, and we moved from there, spoke on some of the laws that governs the kingdom in terms of wisdom and wealth. And so we're going to touch on that. Bishop Manny is going to kick us off with a little bit of that, and then we're just going to flow from there as well. Bishop Horn has still got some things to say. They're going to be with us for about 10 minutes, so fasten your seatbelts. Die manne gaat nou loop, die Boeing is al in die lug. Ons gaan nou vlieg. Bishop.
Thank you, Pastor Clay. Yes, we've dealt with, you know, in February, with wealth and wisdom. There's one scripture that I love in the Bible, and it has nothing to do with money.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
I love the scripture so much. It says in the book of Colossians 1, verse 13, it says, God has delivered us out of the power of darkness and translated us into the kingdom of the Son of His love. Now, we all know that word translated. To be translated means that we've been taken out of one place.
Yeah.
We've been placed into another place.
Yeah.
And so it now simply means that our citizenship, we are in this world,
but
from this world. So my citizenship is not first, I'm a South African.
Come on. My
citizenship is first, I'm kingdom.
I'm a kingdom citizen. Yes.
So it simply means that the world system now have no right to dictate unto me what I can have and what I can't have.
Because I live from another kingdom.
I've lived from another kingdom. That kingdom do have a constitution. And that constitution says that I will be the head and not the tail. I will be blessing the city and I will be blessing the field. He will bless my coming in and he will bless my going out. That constitution says that he will supply all of my needs according to his riches in glory. So I live by a constitution that indicates to me that the king of the kingdom have unlimited resources.
There's
no boundaries. And as a kingdom citizen, I have access to that resources. But what becomes important, I gotta live by the laws of that kingdom. Embrace the laws of that kingdom. I gotta embrace the constitution of that kingdom. It gotta be.
I've gotta live in accordance with that laws.
Because here is the deal. Here's the deal, Pastor Clay. If I don't embrace that, if I continue, to don't adhere to the traffic lights law. The traffic lights law simply says if it turns red,
I'm a stop.
If it turns green, I can go.
Sure.
Now if I continue to drive while it turns on red,
come on.
In other words, there will be consequences.
In other words,
the fact for not that following, I'm will work against me.
Come on.
Will work against me. And so now I need to embrace that laws. Yeah. And if I embrace that laws, it works in my favor.
And that is why they always say any law that you violate will meet up with you.
Come on.
And that's why it becomes very vital to understand one of the laws of the kingdom is faith. That you must understand it operates with faith. You got to operate through faith, you know. I always say, and a week ago I said to the church, my life can enjoy what my pockets does not match because I do have faith for what my life needs to enjoy.
Wow. Say that again, Bishop. Say that again.
And people don't understand that principle that your life can enjoy what your pockets and your bank account does not match.
Because when you
have faith, one of the principles of that kingdom. And one of the laws that is vitally important in that kingdom, you know.
You gotta have faith
to operate and to function.
Hence we find, Bishop Horn and Pastor Clay, that if you're in the kingdom, you now have embraced the kingdom laws, the kingdom constitution. You live by the constitution. You would find that you would apply for a job. You don't have the credentials, the qualifications for the job. You will get it. The world system disqualify you. The kingdom qualifies you. Because it's a different set of
laws. It's sure.
And then there's promises that the Lord says. You know, one promise I spoke about on Sunday that promised us a guaranteed harvest. We're gonna treat the poor right. You know, Proverbs 19:17 says, he that had pity upon the poor lended unto the Lord and that which he had given. He, God himself, will pay them back. God voor die waarborg.
Sure.
Even moet as jy so 'n leerling wil gaan maak.
He swore by himself.
I by himself. Hy sit sy reputasie op die spel. Ek self sal jou uitsort.
Sure.
Have put you in the pool.
Wow. And die skrif laat ons weet that the poor you'll have with you always.
En daarom sê, en ek hou van die skrif in die Afrikaanse weergawe sê, hy wat die goed van die aarde besit en sy broer gesien gebrek lei. Yeah. Hoe kan die liefde van Christus in
so hard? Sure. Yeah. It's like when I'm cold and I come to you and I say, man, I'm cold, and say, well, I'll pray for you, you know, that you get warm.
Exactly.
Meanwhile, I've had 3 jerseys there where you can share, you can ingee at least, you know.
Yes.
But anyway, wow, that's powerful.
Yes. Yeah.
You want to carry on?
Let me just add one point. And so it becomes critical as we deal with wisdom and wealth. Because it becomes critical for us, Bishop Horn, that we must understand the principle of choices.
The principle of choices.
Yeah. In other words, you know, the choices that we make.
Come on.
You know, where we are in life is a result of the choices that we have made.
Come on.
And so many times where we are has nothing to do with the economy of the country.
Choices,
you know, because our lives are not governed by recessions and the economy situation, because we are kingdom.
Yeah.
And so the choices that we make, and so if we have no plan, no direction, even our money will be directionless.
You know,
it becomes important. The choices becomes critical that we make as to where we will find ourselves.
Before Bishop Horn jumps in, I like it just on the decision aspect of it. We've got about 4 minutes left with the bishops. It says, there's a saying that goes, it goes like this: when you are born, you resemble your parents.
Yes, sir.
But when you die, you resemble your decisions. Yes, and your choices.
Yes, sir.
And that is so true. As you say,
it's true, yes. It's very vital, what Bishop Manny said. I think I mentioned on a few weeks back about the importance, especially on choices, you know. And I said that, and I put it this way. I said, the fun that you have today, your fun will never tell you the end result.
Sure.
And the consequences,
of that fun that
you enjoy today.
That's why it's vitally
important to make the right
choices.
In the council.
And that's why you have to have that, coming back to that beginning part that we spoke about, you have to have wise counsel around you. Because in the council of many, you get the wisdom of God.
Yes.
And we know that the wisdom of God is the principal thing.
Yes,
absolutely.
Yeah.
With
so,
our wealth, we're going to make a choice.
Yeah.
Whether I'm going to be a giver,
or
whether I'm going to be a spender.
Sure.
You understand?
Yeah.
Because if I'm a giver, it becomes a lifestyle.
Yeah, yeah.
If I'm a spender, it will become a habit.
And so
the deal is when something becomes a habit, habit needs to be fed.
You've
got to feed it.
You
will buy stuff that you don't have. You will make choices because you're going to feed the habit continually. But when you a giver, it becomes a lifestyle.
Yeah.
And so now you will start to see harvest. Because the Bible teaches us if you give, it shall come back unto you.
And the thing that really you know, just of late reminded me of what you're saying now, Bishop, is the whole thing about, you know, when we in that mode where we not givers but spenders, you know, then what happens is, because of that habit,
yes, sir,
we start to adjust the Bible.
Yes, sir. We now compromise.
You've been now compromised. You know, now
to fit our intentions.
To fit our lifestyle, our habit, you know. And it's like the Bible is okay.
Yes, sir.
Until it contradicts my lifestyle.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Bishop Horn, you wanna
maybe a last thought?
It's 14 minutes past. You got like just.
Yes, no, I just wanna encourage someone today.
Yeah.
From what was said today, you know, get yourself into a place whereby you don't get stuck into what you believe you're okay with.
You
need to grow beyond yesterday.
Sure.
And if
sure,
you grow,
sure.
if you really want to grow beyond yesterday, you got to be intentional about your growth.
Wow, awesome, Bishop. Any last thoughts?
Last thought. I want to say to somebody today that you can grow.
you got what it takes to grow.
Sure.
Absolutely.
Sure.
Because the Bible says in the book of Exodus 1:12, and the more they afflicted them.
Come on. Yeah.
Look, the new king on the block, he said, increase their labor.
Let them work.
Because we have a problem with it. And so I came more. To say, the more.
The more, yeah.
The more the enemy tries.
Sure.
The more
growing.
They talk about
sure.
you.
Yeah.
The more they say you're not going to make it.
Yeah,
the
yeah.
more they write you off.
Yeah.
The more they gossip
sure.
about you.
Yeah.
I mean, the more know
that
you do have what it takes to grow, because you are God's chosen one.
Wow.
Amen.
Amen.
You are royal.
Wow.
Amen.
You. Powerful.
And so just do what God has commanded us to do. And I believe this is our season to grow.
Yeah. Amen. Wow. We've come to the end of the program with the bishops. They have to go because they've got another appointment. So I just want to say again, Bishop Manny, Bishop Andre, thank you so much for taking time out today to come and pop in and still be part of the program today. Really, really thankful and grateful that you guys came out. Traveling Mercy is back home and to your appointment. And thank you so much for coming. I really, really appreciate it.
Thank you to you, Pastor Clay, for having us. It's always nice to be with you, and we celebrate what God is doing through your life with this program. I believe it's a great platform to communicate with people all over the world, you know, advancing God's kingdom. And so God bless you. Thank you to all the listeners who have tuned in today, those who got online.
Yeah.
God bless you all. Amen. And also to the staff here, we want to say thank you for having us.
Yeah.
God bless you all.
Thank you. Okay. Yeah, we're going to go to just a piece of music while the bishops depart, and then my wife is going to join me again. She's going to come in for the last 30 minutes or so. We're going to chat to you. So over and out for now, and we'll see you in a moment.
You are listening to Radio Yesterova.
Our station, our talent, our people.
Cause I'm ready.
It's the beat to the beat to the J-A-Y. It has a down. Lyrically, I flow sick like the blue butter. My profile,
holy hustler style.
Souls are clocked by El Cristo Messiah. Hell full of killers.
Certified.
Yo, cats on some time. Wanna be killers. Rookie no hitters. Lyrical Godzillas. BBJ, nothing but a plan in the man. Putting it down with heads not said.
You better get it while the getting is good.
Rati.
You are listening to Radio Yesterova. You are listening to Radio Yesterova.
Radio
Yesterova.
Our station, our talent, our people.
Di Dung Rakhi. Yo, what a session we just had with Bishop Manny Niekerk and Pastor Bishop Andre Horn. And so thankful. And as they busy driving to their next appointment, thank you so much again, bishops, for taking the time out. It is highly appreciated. And also the same to everybody that's tuned in. Thank you so much for tuning in. But and now I have my beautiful wife again with me, co-piloting for the rest of the program. We've got about 20, 25 minutes left. And I'm just going to give her an opportunity to greet. And then we'll take it from there.
Good afternoon, everybody in Radio Easter of a Land. What a show it has been thus far, and I'm so thankful for the bishops that was here today encouraging us with a word of wisdom, many words of wisdom, and also just enlightening us in so many areas. And I think I'm going to listen to the program again and again just to get that really stuck into my spirit, into my heart, because what they have shared is true wisdom and understanding and knowledge that will just take you further. As we say, our tagline is challenging mindsets in order to change lives. And I truly trust that what has been shared thus far has really challenged you to change in some area of your life. And I know it has changed my life. I took some notes of some of the nuggets that were shared, and it was really, really encouraging and inspiring.
Yeah, awesome. Let me just acknowledge again some people that we have not had the opportunity to acknowledge, that even if you just liked the program. I see Karenique Wessel, she liked the program as well. She's part of Kunjalo Love Fellowship Tabernacle. Edwin Oquist, I mentioned him. Kylo Charles, Pastor Raymond Miles, I see, has also been on. Virgil Bartman, Samantha Arons, Pastor Cammy Fisher from Austin, our friend Lynn Tamlin Watts all the way from the UK, and then also Wendy Swartz out from Musenberg side. Thank you guys for tuning in. Pastor Antonina Niekerk said, God bless you, Pastor Klein, and thank you, ma'am. Then we also have Pastor Tanswell David. So he was our guest last week, him and his wife, Pastor Tanswell David. So thank you so much for tuning in. And yeah, we're going to see you guys soon. Looking forward to seeing you guys again. Evelyn, our friend for like 30 odd years. Powerful teaching. She's all the way out from in Canada at the moment. So thank you for tuning in. And then also, let me just go down the list here. Again, Pastor Antonina. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah, teaching. Thank you so much. Yeah, cross culture. I just want to miss anybody. Thank you so much. Okay, there we go. Yeah, so I mean, just to quickly recap what we were talking about, just one or two things that I made a note of that I want to bring in. Yeah, just elaborate again on one of the things that Bishop Manny said. You know, if you have an issue or a problem, if you don't confront it, you know, then you will never change.
Absolutely.
Out of that situation that you're in. You have to confront. You have to confront it. You have to be open with yourself. You have to be honest with yourself and confront that thing, whatever it might be. And if you need help, then seek out people that can help. Brothers and sisters that you trust, seek them out and say, hey, I've got a problem in this area, or I'm battling in that area. This is the practical side of that. And sometimes you gotta change now in order to get out of that thing and to develop new patterns. You gotta put some boundaries in place for yourself. If you have, just as an example, if you had a problem with alcohol or drinking or whatever the case might be, you know, and you wanna change the pattern of that, then you can't go sit in the pub every week to go and watch the game. Find somewhere else to go and watch the game then, because otherwise the temptation will be there all the time. And it might trip you up again, and that you fall back into that. So that's one thing that I wanted to mention. Bishop Horn said one thing as well, which is so powerful. He says, don't allow your past to dictate what your future will look like. Don't allow your past to dictate or to determine what your future will look like. And that is so important. Paul writes in Philippians chapter 3 from verse 13, he says, forgetting what lies behind and stretching forward. And very often we get so down on ourselves because people have a tendency to remind us of yesterday. And they tend to remind us of what we did 10 years ago and 12 years ago. And they can't see that God has been busy working in us and changing us. And the key thing is, you know, even if you're changing slowly, make the necessary adjustments so that you can end up where God wants you to end up.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Anything you want to add there, babe?
Absolutely. I am of the opinion that, like Bishop Manny has said, people make mistakes. We all make mistakes. Believers are not perfect people. We make mistakes, but the main thing is that we always, once we've fallen, we get back up again. We don't stay down. We have to get back up, and we have to train ourselves to become that person. Maturity is something that you grow into.
Yeah.
You grow from physically from a baby to a teenager to an adult, and so spiritually you grow as well.
Yeah.
So we need to just tell ourselves or remind ourselves what the future holds for us and where we want to go, what our goals are. And if you make that mistake, It's fine.
Yeah.
Just get back up again and start moving into the right direction for your life.
Yeah, and sometimes I think sometimes we just need to change. You know, we spoke about mindset changes and shifting your mind is to understand that, you know, that if you make a mistake, is that does not define who you are. You know, that is not your departure point. Your departure point is Christ, as Bishop Manny said. He's the pattern. So don't let the mistake define you or govern your life. Look to Christ. The Bible speaks about fixing our eyes on Jesus. This race that we're running, you cannot run it effectively if your eyes is not fixed on Jesus. So we fix our eyes on Jesus. He's the reference point. In fact, it says in the Amplified of that same verse, it adds a little bit extra, and it says, fixing our eyes on Jesus and looking away from everything else that distracts.
Absolutely.
And so don't let the distractions become who you are. Fix your eyes on Jesus. And let's run the race like that, running from a point of a understanding of victory, understanding that you are an overcomer, and you know, start walking your life out from that perspective and not from the mistake perspective.
Amen.
Is there anything that you maybe made notes of that you wanted that stood out for you?
Can I go on?
Yeah, I love what Bishop Manny said as well towards the end. Speaking about you know, that we're in a different kingdom, and that God has translated us through His Son. And the thing is, with what we must understand is from that scripture is that God doesn't take you out of something in order to leave you. He takes you out in order to take you in. God doesn't bring you out and then just leave you. He takes you out in order to take you in. And so that is important because, you know, He is the one that does the doing, if I can put it like that. It says in Romans, it speaks about, you know, what the law couldn't do, God did. And so we have to respond to the God did. You know, we act and we walk from that particular perspective. That's important that we see that. So that will transform our lives to walk in an upright manner, to walk righteously. So that's important. I'm reminded, just as an example again, years ago, I think I shared this already on the show as well. I wanted to watch the South African team, the Springboks, play against the All Blacks a couple of years ago, and when VCRs were still in. And so I wasn't able to watch it live, and so I set the VCR, the video recorder, I set it to record the game for me. And so while I was out and about the whole day, I would, everywhere that I came, I would say to people, please don't tell me the score. I steered away from where I could see the score, because my thought was, when I get back home later in the evening or in the afternoon, then I would watch the game, the recording of the game, and to me it would be as if I was watching it live, because I didn't know the score then, I wouldn't know the score and all of that kind of stuff. And so got through the whole day not knowing the score and looking forward to watch the game. And then when I walked in, the minute I walked into the house, my son Matthew shouted at me and said, "Daddy, the Springboks won," and he gave the score. So after a whole day of trying not to find out the score, walked into the house, and the one place where I thought, now I'm going to find out the score by watching the game, he shouted out the score to me as I walked through the door. Anyway, so now watching the game, I was watching the game already knowing the outcome. Okay, I knew that the Springboks had won. And so regardless of what happened during the game, even while I was watching the recording of the game, if two or three players were sent off and we were behind on points and all of that, listen, I wouldn't be fretting. I wouldn't be worried, we're going to lose this game or anything like that, because I already knew the final score. And so in our walk with God, we need to understand that Jesus has already won the battle. So we don't run this race in order to win. We run this race because he's already won. Mm-hmm. And so we just need to enforce that victory in our daily lives. So we live Christ. We live from that winning position. We live from that and we execute from there.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's now 5:30. We've got about 10-15 minutes left of the program. Thank you so much for sticking with us. Gail Admiral says powerful. Thank you so much, Gail, for tuning in as well. And I trust that this show, I know that it's been a blessing to
absolutely
your heart.
It's
today.
A really good show.
Yeah, so we're going to go to the next piece of music, and then we come back and we'll continue with the program.
You are listening to Radio Yesterova.
Yeah. Molweni makhaya, singu Radio East River, sifumaneka kuzo zonke social media platforms.
Okay, so you must say, come on. Can you feel it? Hey? Can you feel it? Yeah, bro. Can you feel it? Hey? One time. Can you feel it? Hey? Hold on, come on. One, two. Okay. Two, three, four, five, go. We'll be right back.
are listening to Radio Yesterova.
Jou kom terug op Radio Yesterova.
Our station, our talent, our people.
Die ding rukkie.
Ja, die ding rukkie is Radio Eestere 4, onze stasie, onze talent, onze mensen. And we are still buzzing with what happened in the studio, the wisdom that was forthcoming from the bishops this afternoon. So excited. Yeah, we are live on TikTok as well. And one of the things that Bishop Horn said, which we want to just focus on for the last 10 minutes or so, of the show, he said that the kingdom currency is faith. And so we just want to talk a little bit around faith. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 6 that without faith, mm-hmm. it's impossible to please God. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. And he that comes to God mm-hmm. must believe that he is. And then he goes on to say that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him.
Amen.
But faith, without faith, it's impossible to please God. It doesn't say that it's difficult. It doesn't say that it's sort of this, that, and the other. It says, no, it's impossible to please God without faith. And so we are a faith people. Kingdom people are a faith people. Faith is like Bishop Owen said, is the currency. If we're not in faith, then that's when things start to become all blurry and muddy and muddied, And so we see the whole of chapter 11 of Hebrews, also referred to as the so-called Faith Hall of Fame. We see all of the names mentioned there, the Old Testament patriarchs and so on. And even Sarah's mentioned in there. It says that they found approval with God because of their faith. Yeah, and so faith is paramount to us as believers, as kingdom citizens. It's without faith, like we said, we cannot please God. It's almost like breathing to us. Faith. James chapter 2 speaks about. That faith carries corresponding action. Some scriptures use the word works, or it speaks about faith without corresponding works or action is dead, And the thing that we sometimes confuse is that we think we work in order to please God, and that's not really the right understanding of it. But it says when you're in faith, from faith, works will follow. In other words, you work from faith, not for faith, if you understand what I'm trying to say. So it's not about white knuckle club, oh man, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. No. It's about understanding, because faith, the Bible says, comes. Mm. Faith comes by hearing what?
The word of God.
And so faith is locked up in his word. So when you have word, you have the basis for faith.
Absolutely. Yeah. I think Bishop Horn explained it so nicely. He said, when you don't have money in your bank account, when you don't have anything physical that you can rely on in order for you to make it, then you have something in the kingdom of God that is your currency, that is your connection to heaven, so to speak.
Yeah.
So when you are down to nothing, then you must know that God is up to something, and that God will by the instruction that he gives you, like Pastor Clay say, it's your faith that in the word of God, in the instruction that God gives you, that will activate heaven, that will open up the heavens for you, and that it will allow the blessings and the whatever you need to come from heaven. And sometimes, it's not like Bishop said, it's not just money. When we speak about the currency of heaven, we're not just speaking about money. We're not talking about specifically wealth in that sense, but we are talking about wealth in other areas of your life as well. Health is something that that you desperately need.
Health is wealth.
Health is wealth. And so we need to have our minds really in tune, our minds really renewed concerning the things of the kingdom and how faith works, because it is not just about money, it is about every area of your life. I think Pastor Clay so rightly say sometimes holistic living, your holistic life, every area of your life needs to prosper and every area of your life needs to grow. We can't stagnate in one area and grow in another area. We have to grow holistically so that we can become a healthy, mature person in the Lord, in Christ.
Yeah. Yeah, and so again, just want to reiterate a little bit on the aspect of faith that comes. The Bible says in Romans 10:17, faith comes, and it comes by hearing the word of God. So if there's no word, there's no basis for faith. And I'm thinking of the example where the disciples was in the boat. Jesus had sent them to the other side. After that, they were involved in the miracle of feeding the 5,000 men, besides the women and the children. So this was a huge thing. They were involved in it. They were physically involved in this miracle, and so he sends them. He says, "Get in the boat and go to the other side." Now that should have been enough for them to understand and to know that they would get to the other side, because they had a word. They had instruction, and they would get to the other side. Mm-hmm. And so what happens is, they end up sort of halfway, and this huge storm happens. And so they are afraid, they are fearful. These were experienced fishermen, but the circumstances, the situation that they found themselves in, the storm beating them down, got them to a place where they were fearful, they were afraid. And even when Jesus came walking towards them on the thing that they were afraid of sinking in, they were afraid of sinking now, going under, going down. Here Jesus comes walking on that very thing that they were sinking in, or were going to sink in, or were going to be overcome by. And so they were so afraid, the Bible says that they did not even recognize Jesus. Because fear would stop you from seeing your answers. When you allow fear to grip you, on the one hand it will paralyze you, in other words it will almost push you into inactivity. That's what fear does, because you start to just collapse in a ball of fear, and you don't move, you don't act, because you just fear grips you, and so on the other side, they did not recognize Jesus as he was coming, and so your answer could be walking right towards you, and you would miss it because fear you've put on glasses of fear, your filter is fear, and it won't allow you to recognize your answer. And so Jesus speaks, and the first thing that he says to them is, "Do not be afraid." So Jesus immediately counters the thing that stops them from seeing the answer. He counters that by saying, "Do not be afraid," or "Do not fear." And so Peter hears the voice, and he says, "If it is you, Lord, command me to come." And so now Peter wants to get out of the boat, and he wants to get to where Jesus is. But he says to Jesus, because he understands faith, and he says to Jesus, "Now give me a word." In other words, command me to come. And so Jesus says to him, "Come." And so based on what Jesus commanded him, or the word that he had, and faith comes by what? The word. And so he heard the word "come." And so that was enough then for him to understand that now he had a Hebrews 11:1 happening right basically in that situation. Hebrews 11:1 says, "Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not yet seen." And so when Jesus had come, he had enough substance to step onto. He could step out of the boat and step onto the substance that the word brought. And so when he stepped out, he was on the word. He landed on the word, so to speak. And I always say to people, he wasn't really walking on the water. He was walking on the word that Jesus had given to him to come out, or to come out of the boat. And so, faith is that word that is spoken in your particular situation, because Isaiah chapter 50, what's it, 55, and verse from about verse 8 onwards speaks about that his thoughts are not our thoughts and all of that. But then it goes on to say, and so shall my word be that proceeds from my mouth. It will not return unto me void, but it will accomplish that for which, or it will succeed in the matter for which I sent it. So you have to have what I would call a task-specific word for your circumstance, for your situation, so that you might step, as it were, out of the boat of fear and step onto the task-specific word that is given to you in any given situation or circumstance, and then you'll have that to walk on. Mm. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. My vrou stem saam met my.
Ik stem 100% saam.
Yeah.
We can only but hold on to the faith, hold on to the word of God and what he gives us. Our circumstances and the outside things are always working against us. There's always things that's working against us. 2 Corinthians 5:7 says, we walk by faith and not by sight.
Wow, powerful
and
scripture,
that means,
yes.
That not by sight means the way that things appear. And many times we take what happens around us as our reality, when in actual fact it is not our true reality. What happens in the natural to us is the natural outflow of life. But we are spiritual beings, so we live from our spirituality. We live from above and not beneath. We live from heaven and not the earth. So we need to experience things in a spiritual realm. Victory is in the spiritual realm. When we have faith in God and his word, then we are walking upon the things that has already been declared and already been placed, and already the victory has already been won. So all we need to do is just to stand firm on the word of God, proclaim the word of God, speak it. It's not only just good enough for us to think the word of God and to have it in our hearts, but we also need to declare the word of God so that we can set the atmosphere, we can change the atmosphere, change the what we are experiencing, and have the manifest presence of God arrive on the scene, so to speak. We know that God is an omnipresent God, he's everywhere.
Yeah.
And but as in Genesis 1, the way that God created the heavens and the earth, the scripture says in Genesis 2, I think, that the Spirit was hovering above the surface of the deep. And we know from the scriptures that the earth was formless and void. There was nothing going on. And so before creation appeared out of God, God spoke a word. God said, let there be light. Mm. And the first let there be light God spoke was let my presence come in. Put me in the space, put me in the atmosphere. And then after that, when God started speaking, things started to happen. So it is imperative, it is very important that we don't only carry the word in our heart, but that we speak it. Because speaking is making a proclamation, is proclaiming, is making a declaration. And when we speak the word of God, we speak things that already are, that already exist, that as it is in heaven, so it may be with us.
Yeah. Awesome. Yeah, I love the scripture you started out there with, baby. It says in 2 Corinthians 5:7 that without faith, it says we walk by faith and not by sight. And the word sight there literally means the way things appear, which is a reference really to the things that we perceive or interact with via the senses, the natural senses. So he's basically saying, we should not walk, or we walk not by the way things appear or by the things that we naturally perceive, but we walk by faith. or the word of God, then we walk by the word of God, the instruction of God, and that is very, very important, because very often when we perceive things with our senses, with our natural senses, not everything that you perceive with your natural senses is bad. We're not saying that, but the thing is, very often what we look at, when we look at things and the way things appear, then that starts to transform our thinking in a negative way, mm-hmm. because mostly the things that we see these days are negative. So that starts to infiltrate our thinking, and we allow the birds to nest in our hair, so to speak. And so it's important that we understand that, we have to walk by faith. Yeah, we've come to the end of the program, unfortunately. You know, I could go on for another hour and a half, 2 hours, but it's 7 minutes before six. And I just want to say thank you so much for everybody that's tuned in. Thank you so much for taking time out of your schedule. I see that we're starting to form a base of regulars that tune in every week, and so we are so thankful. Please tell people about the program. Tell people about the radio station. Share the broadcast. Even now, once we're done, take a copy of the link and share it onto your timeline. Share it in your WhatsApp groups if you know it was a blessing, because people can watch it back whenever they have time, when they have data or when they had Wi-Fi, they can watch it back. And so thank you so much. Baby, you want to just greet and then we're going to close out.
Yes, what a powerful show we had. And thank you once again to Bishop Manny and Bishop Andre Horn for being with us this afternoon. And we value and appreciate your wisdom and understanding that you brought forth. So many wealthy things, so much have been shared, so many treasures have been brought out of the kingdom of God. And we would like for you to just share this with the rest of the world. I think especially young men and women of God who are starting out, who are in the beginning stages of ministry, they need to hear these wisdom keys. They need to know and understand what it is all about before they get out there. So share this broadcast, if you don't mind. We would highly, highly appreciate it. It will bless somebody so greatly if you do that. But thank you for being with us this afternoon. God bless and goodbye.
Yeah, over and out. See you same time next week. We'll be back next week. Blessings. Bye-bye.
You are listening to Radio Israel.
You are listening to Radio Yesterova.
Do you want to take your business to the next level? Advertise with Radio Yesterova by emailing us at admin@radioyesterova.co.za.
Only see the worst in me. Can I tell y'all one more time? I said he saw the best in me. When everyone else around could only see the worst in me. I wish I had a witness tonight. All I need is one.
Saw the best in me.
When everyone else around me,
could only see
the worst in me. Does anybody have that testimony? When folk walked you off, said you would never make it, what did he see?
He saw the best in me.
When everyone else around me asked, oh. Can I tell y'all one more thing? I just need to tell you one more thing. Listen to this. See, he's mine, and I am his. It doesn't matter what I did. He only sees me for who I am. Does anybody know that tonight? Oh, see, he is mine. And I am here. Said it doesn't matter what I did. See, he only sees me.